Today is the history of a goddess who lived with us, who never said, "I don't have food to feed," when someone asked her, who knows very well serving hunger is serving God, who knows filling someone's stomach is filling their heart. A woman who came all the way from heaven to feed the one who is hungry. Today is the story of a woman of substance, Sri Dokka Sitamma. Sri Dokka Sitamma was born in 1841 October in a village of Mandapeta, Andhra Pradesh. Her father Bhavani Shankar used to feed the poor and people, not when he gets chance, but every day who asks him. He is also called Bhuvanna for the way he used to offer food to people every day. Sitamma inherited this noble trait from his father. She evolved from the age she gained conscious. She continued though her mother passed away, and also continued the same auspicious deed even after marrying to Dokka Venkata Joganna from Lankala Gannavaram. Our recognition should be extended to her husband also, as he also supported her the way she wanted to do. She only wants to know whether the stomach is empty or not. That's it. Not what the time is, not who the person is. There is never no from her side. She fed from kids to old, rags to rich, upon all according to their needs. Once, then Emperor of India, King Edward VII invited her to the celebration of his anniversary along with other guests to Delhi. But Sitamma politely declined the invitation, saying, "I never fed the empty stomach for recognition. Sorry." Later on demand by King Edward VII, Sitamma's photo was taken. Then he enlarged the photograph and placed on the chair where she was to sit during the celebration. Another time, she was on her way to visit temple in Palanquin. After some distance, the carriers tired and stopped. Meanwhile, few passerbys who were hungry were talking to themselves, "In some time, we shall reach to Sitamma house so that our empty stomach is fed by the mother of food, Dokka Sitamma." Listening to their conversation, she discontinued her visit to temple and remitted back to home to prepare food. There are many instances like this where she proved herself as goddess of food. Even till her last breath, she served food, and her legacy was continued by that bloodline. There are three things we should learn from her life. 1. Children learn from the way you lead life, not by the way you teach them. As Sitamma learned from her father, and her children learn from her. 2. Not to say no for the empty stomach. As she fed a person who shouted he isn't hungry, who lost in darkness in storm. She never watched time, whether it's midnight or early morning, there's no one who starved around her. 3. Her commitment and strong will to offer food every day. That's why still there is a place by her name where food is offered every day. Hail Dokka Sitamma, long live her values.
Follow us on Facebook and Instagram and subscribe us on YouTube at Ragashree Video.